Hello students, in this video let's solve exercise 3.2 of your third chapter. So first problem, if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. What is the number? Okay, so this we have to, the statement is given, okay. So, what we should do, we should write this in the form of a linear equation. Okay. So, let's say we don't know the number. So, what they are telling, that number when it is subtracted, okay, from 1 by 2 and multiply that result by 1 by 2, the final answer we will get 1 by 8. So, let us take the unknown number as x. Okay. So, this given we have to write in the form of linear equation. So, let's write. Given that if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. Given data only we are writing. Okay. So, this is how we have to write. So, this number, first let's start with x. Okay, x is there. Subtract 1 by 2. So, x minus 1 by 2. Okay. And multiply the result by 1 by 2. This result, x minus 1 by 2, this result we are going to multiply by 1 more 1 by 2. Okay. So, this is how we have to, step by step we have to write. So, x be the unknown number and it is given when x minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, the answer is 1 by 8. That is in the LHS. Okay, this is how we have to write in the form of linear equation. So, linear equation, in the previous video itself I told. So, x will be a variable with the power of 1. Okay, so it can be multiplied by any constant and any constant can be added to it. So, it is of the form ax plus b equal to 0. Okay. So, anything, any key number it can be. So, not only 0, anything it can be, but in this form only it should be. Okay, like that we wrote now. So, let's continue furthermore to solve and find out what is x. In the previous exercise, it is to solve and find out the value of x. That only we are going to do now. Okay, first step is to find in, write in the form of linear equation. The next step is to find the value of x. That is, to the question. So, here they have asked for any number. Okay, that number what it is that we are going to find out and find the value of x. Obviously, after finding x, that's a number. Okay. So, next step. So, in the previous slide, you saw 1 by 2 is here. Okay, 1 by 2 is here. So, this is in the multiplication. 1 by 2 into this bracket. Okay. So, this in the division it is. So, when it goes to RHS, it will be go as multiplication. That's why here we have 1 by 8 into 2. Okay. So, here 8 and 2 can be cancelled. So, 2 4s are 8. So, here you will get 4, 1 by 4. Okay. So, now in order to have only x, so this 1 minus 1 by 2 we have to take to the RHS. Correct. So, this we can do in two ways. One is transposing and one is we have to bring it to 0. No, so minus 1 by 2 is there. If you add plus 1 by 2, both will get cancelled. So, either way you can do. Either add plus 1 by 2 or take this minus 1 by 2, that side of equal to. So, that is transposing. When it is minus here, when it goes to that side of RHS, okay. When it goes there, it will go in plus. This and all we did in the previous exercise. Just I am giving a recall. So, this minus 1 by 2 when it went to the RHS, it came as plus 1 by 2. Okay. So, now we have to take LCM because these two fractions are having different denominator. So, in order to bring same denominator, we have to take LCM. I already told when smaller number is a... It's what to say, multiple of this one. Both are multiple of 2. Okay. So, 4 is a multiple of 2. So, we can take that 4 as a LCM. So, 4 as LCM. So, what into 2 will give you 4? So, 2 into 2 will give you 4. So multiply that in the numerator. So 1 into 2 is 2. Okay. So this is how you have to bring. Then 1 plus 2 is 3. So x is equal to 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 is the required number. Okay. So first we wrote no x as the number. So that number is 3 by 4. That's the answer. Let's move to the next question. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meters. Its length is 2 meters, more than twice its breadth. What are the length and breadth of the pool? Okay. So what is given in the question? Perimeter is given and some data is also given. Length is 2 meters, more than twice its breadth. What is the length and breadth? We have to find out. So let's start. So this is the rectangle. So let's take breadth as x. Okay. Breadth x means length is 2 meter more than twice of breadth. That's why we are writing 2 into x plus 2. Okay. 2 times of breadth plus 2. That is only going to give us length. That's what given in the question. Okay. Length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. So x is breadth means twice means 2 times 2x. Then 2 more meter is more. Plus, that's why we are writing plus 2. Understood? So with this we can start solving. Okay, let the breadth of the pool be x meter. Length is equal to 2x plus 2 meter. So what is the perimeter? It's given as 154 meter. But what's the perimeter formula? Formula is 2 into L plus B. Okay, rectangle formula is 2 into L plus B. So now we have to substitute this value. Then only we can find out what is x. Okay, so substituting the value. 2 into, this is L value, this is breadth value. Okay. L is 2x plus 2 and this is breadth x. Okay, equal to 154, that is given in question. So we have to remove the brackets and simplify. Okay, so after removing the bracket, you will have 2x plus x. So that can be, these are like terms. In the first video I told no, so like terms, 2x and x are like terms. Same variable with the same exponent. Exponent means power. Same variable with the same power means then they are like terms. That only have to be added. Okay. So 2x plus x, that will become 3x and plus 2. That's a constant that will stand alone. You should not add to that. Okay. So 3x plus 2, that's what will be inside the bracket. Now this 2 is this side. Okay. So solving the bracket. Okay, you can do like this, or you straight away you can take this 2 to this side also. Anyhow you can do. Here it's done like solving the bracket. We have multiplied inside the bracket. Okay. So transposing this 4 to this side. That RHS means, so plus 4 will become minus 4. That's what written here. Plus 2 minus. Okay. So x is equal to 6x is equal to 150. Okay, so x is equal to 150 divided by 6. Here it is multiplication means when it comes to the RHS, it will be in division. Transposing 6 from multiply to division. That's what written here. Okay, so 150 divided by 6 is 25. So that's what the breadth value. Here itself you should not stop. You should still more write what it is asked in the question. We have found out only what is x. Okay. In the previous exercise, we will stop here because they asked to solve only till here. But here, it's not like that. It's a word problem. So, you have to continue. Okay. Breadth is 25 meter. Then, what is length? 2x plus 2. Okay. So, 2 substituting the value of x. 2 into 25 plus 2. Okay. So, first solve this one. So, 50 plus 2, that is 52 meter. Okay. Understood? Next problem. The base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. The perimeter of the triangle is 4, 2 by 15 centimeter. What is the length of either of the remaining equal sides? Okay. So, with this question, we can come, we should first know what is an isosceles triangle. What is an isosceles triangle? Isosceles triangle will have two sides equal. Okay, only two sides will be equal, one will be different. So that's what meaning of isosceles triangle. So base they have given and perimeter they have given. Perimeter means how we found for rectangle. Same way, adding the three sides, that is a perimeter. Okay, that is also given. We have to find out what is the length of the remaining equal sides. Okay, so those two sides are equal. So this is a picture we can draw from the question. Okay, in the question they will give this much only. This diagram we should draw and we should find out. Okay, base they have given. So remaining two sides same only. Okay, whatever side this side it is having, that only this side will also have. So that number we are taking as x. Okay, so let's start now. Base of the isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. Let the length of each of equal sides of triangle be x centimeter. Perimeter of triangle equal to sum of the three sides. Okay, no formula and all we don't have. We have to add the three sides. That's it. Okay, that is equal to x plus 4 by 3 centimeter. First x, second x and base. That's what we are adding here. X plus 4 by 3 centimeter. So, x plus x is 2x plus 4 by 3 centimeter. So, this value what they have given? They have given 4, 2 by 15. Okay, this is a mixed fraction. So, we have to, what we have to do? So, what we have to do, we have to find out what's the value of 4, 5 by 15. So, how to find out that? So, that we have to do like this. We have to multiply here. Okay. 4 and 15 we should multiply. And this 2 we should add. That's a remainder actually. Okay, so like this you have to do. So this number have to be multiplied and what result you are getting, that number with that number, this two have to be added. Okay, that's how you have to find out the value for mixed fraction. Okay, okay, so if you do like this, 15 into 4 is 60 plus 2. That's why you are getting 62 divided by 15. Okay. So, this side 4 by 3 is there. No, that you are bringing to the RHS. So, transposing 4 by 3 from plus to minus. Here it is plus. So, when it comes to RHS, it will be in minus. So, both the denominators are not same. So, we have to take LCM. Okay. LCM is 15. Okay, so 15 is a multiple of 3. So, bigger number we have to take it as LCM. So, 15 is LCM. So, 62 minus 20. Okay, why 20 is coming here? Okay, what into, if you, into 3 if you do, we will get 15 into 5. Okay, 5, 3 5s are 15. So, that 5 you have to multiply with this numerator. So, 4 into 5 is 20. Okay, so 62 minus 20 divided by 15, that is 42 by 15. Okay, so that side of the LHS side you had 2, no, so that will come as 1 by 2. Okay, when it is in multiplication, when it comes to RHS, it will come as division. Okay, so by simplifying, you will get 21 divided by 15 equal to 7 by 5. Okay, so 7 by 5, how to make it as mixed fraction? So, here you have a rough column. Okay, so 7 divided by 5. So, how many times 5 will go in 7? One time. So, write the quotient as 1 and you will write 5 here. So, 7 minus 5 is 2. Furthermore, we can't do, so we have to turn this into a mixed fraction. So, what will happen? This denominator, this is denominator, okay, that will come here, then this numerator, this remainder only is the numerator that will come here, and the quotient will come as the number here. Understood? So like a